Om Shanti. Good afternoon. क्या हुआ?
Om Shanti.
थक गए या सीरियस बहुत है या बोर हो रहे हैं क्या हुआ? Why do we greet each other? Why do we greet each other? You know, every time, not just now, but every day, day in and day out, we meet the same people, whether it is family at home, we greet each other, whether we enter our workplace, and every person we meet, we go, good morning, good afternoon. What's the purpose? To acknowledge the person. To? Or? To connect and? To bring cheer to? So I said good afternoon. And I said Om Shanti. So I brought cheer to myself. Now? ऐसे होके नहीं बैठना है ऐसे होके बैठने से हम बहुत टाइट टाइट हो जाते हैं sometimes nowadays you meet someone and you say good afternoon and the other person will say afternoon so this is the way we're changing our life because of which we're shifting from a conscious way of living to a very automated and a mechanical way of living. And when someone starts living in a very automated, mechanical way, then we tend to lose enjoying life. We're living life, but we're not enjoying life. There's a difference between living life, living, roz subah uth rahe hain, तैयार हो रहे हैं ऑफिस जा रहे हैं काम कर रहे हैं घर आ रहे हैं परिवार का ध्यान रख रहे हैं लिविंग लाइफ एंजॉयिंग लाइफ व्हाट वुड बी द डिफरेंस बिटवीन लिविंग लाइफ एंड एंजॉयिंग लाइफ मस्ती में कर रहे हैं अच्छा और क्या कर रहे हैं लेट्स सिट टू मिनट्स इन साइलेंस एंड लेट्स चेक आवर ओन लाइफ आप सब भी बैठ जाएंगे हो गई फोटो अपनी यू नो हिज रोल ऑफ कोर्स इज एज अ फोटोग्राफर बट ऑल ऑफ अस ऑल्सो नाउ डेज कैरी अ कैमरा विद अस एंड द मिनट देयर इज अ सीन बिफोर अस वी विल फर्स्ट वांट टू क्लिक अ फोटोग्राफ व्हाट हैपेंस वी गेट सो यूज्ड टू डूइंग दैट द मिनट देयर इज अ सीन वेदर एट होम आउटसाइड वी डूइंग दिस And we feel we're trying to capture the moment. Now once we capture the moment, what are we going to do? We are going to put the photo either on WhatsApp or on Facebook and then we will wait for people to like that moment. Can we like that moment in the photo? Or were we supposed to experience that moment when it was happening? When there is a moment, I can either experience the moment or I can click a picture of the moment. I can't do both. I can't do both. It's all a question of few seconds. And experiencing that moment would mean radiating my vibration to that scene. And experiencing the vibrations of the other people in that scene. That can only happen in the moment. The picture will have no vibration. So we need to capture the moment here. But we want to capture the moment on our camera. And we forget to capture the experience of that moment here. And then we will put it on Facebook and wait for other people to like that picture. And suppose my friends don't click like on the picture, then I go, how many likes? I was supposed to like the moment. If I did not like the moment, how can my friends like the picture of the moment? Not possible. So we're living life more for others. other people rather for us. So try. We don't need photographs. Nahi zarurat hai. Ek ek scene aayega, scene bit jayega. Vaisa scene jeevan mein dubhara nahi aayega. Kabhi nahi aayega. To us scene ko jeevan mein enjoy kare, to uski photo ki kabhi zarurat nahi padegi. Uska experience yahan reh jayega. What's more important, the photo of the moment or the experience of the moment? Sometimes we're so busy clicking the photo that we can even get angry with the other person in the picture. There was once, I'll tell you what happened. I was sitting with Dadiji, the senior most of the organization, and there was another brother who was sitting next to her, a celebrity in today's world, one of the top actors of the industry. And he came to meet me and I took him to meet Dadi. And I said, Dadi, give him a meditation experience, because he was a little upset about something. And this soul did not know how to meditate, he's never done it before. But when he was sitting in Dadiji's pure vibration and she was giving him drishti and he's meditating, it was about 5 to 10 minutes, he didn't blink an eye. He was so absorbed by what was happening. People around there wanted to click a photo. And I was blocking their view. So they actually, in the middle of such a beautiful experience that was happening, they were actual of pictures. He doesn't need pictures. By doing that, you would have spoiled the experience that he was having that time. This is happening every time. So from today, we'll use the phone only as a phone. You know? Because when I entered, everyone was sitting with a phone like this, taking pictures. Not needed. Not needed. Enjoy every moment. There's so much to give and so much to take from every moment. Technology is shifting us to become more mechanical rather than experiencing what we had to do. Today we'd rather wish people on messages rather than meet them and call them up. Easier message. How many people called up each other on Holi? We're giving WhatsApp, happy Holi. Oh yeah. And nowadays you will have posters and videos and everything. Everyone will copy the same one, forward it to everyone. Everyone seeing the same thing again and again and again. Same picture, same message, same video. No feeling. No feeling. Picture made by someone else. Video created by someone else. Sent by me to you. Where's my feeling in that? Nothing. So what is missing is the vibrations that we have to give each other. And because those vibrations are missing, life is becoming little. It's like a flower. One is the true flower, one is a plastic flower. Nowadays you get extremely beautiful artificial flowers. You can't even make out sometimes, is it true or is it artificial? They're so beautifully made. But, khushbu to nahi hai na? Khushbu to nahi hai. Hamari jeevan bhi wo phoolon ki tarah ho gayi hai. Bahut sundar hai, lekin khushbu kya hoti ja rahi hai? Jaati ja rahi hai. So let's close our eyes. Sit for 2 minutes. Visualize your life. Just look at yourself. Just a few questions I need to ask myself today. Can I be happy with everyone, everywhere, every time. Can I be happy always? What's the one change I would like to create today which will make my life a beautiful experience? What is the one change I would want in my life to happen today? It could be something in my relationships, it could be to do with my physical health. It could be to do with how I feel. It could be to do with work. What's the one change, if it happens, it would make my life a beautiful experience? The journey. What's the one change that I would want on the journey of my life? Who's the one person, if they change, it's going to change the way I experience my life? When I hear the word life, what does it mean to me? Life. What does this word mean to me? Om Shanti. What does the word life mean to us? It's in my life. So what does that word mean to us? My life means? No. What does it mean when I say my life? Those are all words, yes. Life is a journey, life is a gift, it's okay. My life, what would come in that? My life. Huh? Being alive. What I experience every moment is my life. What else? Hanji? Remain with yourself. Meri Jeevan, my life. My thoughts, my feelings, my relationship with myself. Breathing in and out is my life. My health. My work. My family, friends is my life. And
between my human life, my
Oh. A balance between my
physical life, my physical self, and my soul, my spirit.
Okay. A balance between my physical life
and my
what all comes under the banner of my physical life?
My relationships with my family, my friends, my health, anything.
What comes under the banner of my spiritual life?
My sadhanas, my relation with my inner self, and anything what I'm aware this is very worrying and spiritual.
Okay, so now we are going to balance between. So now we want to balance between my sadhana, my relationship with myself and my relationship with other people and my work. Okay. Anything else? My life, piche?
My
self, image. Okay.
Am I reaching my purpose in my life?
What is the purpose? What is the purpose of my life? What's the purpose of my life?
To bring happiness
to To bring happiness to others and to be happy with myself is the purpose of my life. Is that okay? How many of us would want that to be the purpose of our life? To bring happiness to others and to be happy with myself. Is that okay? Okay. What would be the order? To bring happiness to others and to be happy myself. Order? Let's look at it hypothetically. How many of you feel it's possible today to make everyone happy every time? Hello, Aliji, possible to make everyone happy every time? I personally have removed that from the agenda of my life. Because, one, it's not possible. Second, when we understand that I am the creator of how I'm feeling, and which means, what can you continue to do? That's all. Aaj nahi to kal, kal nahi to parso. It's like the sun. Don't show happiness, radiate happiness. That's what. It's not in what we do, it's not in how we speak, it is in what we feel. What we think about them is what we radiating to them. Even now creating this thought, but they get irritated. No, even though I do, I've radiated something else. It's very subtle how we think about other people. We expect them to be happy because we are radiating, and when they are not what we want them to be, see, then we get a little disappointed because they've not met up to my expectations, and we will be radiating the opposite of happiness. Happiness means power. Happiness means love. Happiness means respect. And respect means I accept you the way you are. Even if you're not happy, I accept you. Why are they not happy? Now let's think. Why are they not happy? Yeah, that's important. We don't know why people around us are not happy. It's so easy for us to say, but why aren't they happy? We have no idea how much pain, how much trauma, how much misery someone is carrying inside them, and we say, "Maine inke liye itna kiya," they're still not happy. A soul has been on a long journey. We always need to remember this. We keep reading articles, we keep talking about it, we keep sharing it with other people. When it comes to living our life, we forget it. Every time you read Life Positive, you will read every article says soul. So we know the word soul. Every article will use the word karma, so we know the word karma. Every article will say the soul is on the journey and it's changing costumes, we know that. We know that every soul is carrying their sanskars, but when we come to meeting our family, we'll say, my child. my husband, my wife, soul on a journey. How much do we know about that soul? How much do we know about that soul? He read today morning's newspaper. 40-year-old doctor pulled out of the house, brutally murdered. Soul has left the body. The soul has left the body. What is the last experience? What is the last experience? Trauma, betrayal, hatred, pain. This 8-year-old son was standing there. This father, while he was being hit, he must be looking at his son. No. We can't even imagine the pain. No, it's easy to talk and read about it. It's so easy to talk and read about it. But can we imagine the pain of that soul? No. Now, left the body. Within 6 to 7 months, that soul will be in a baby in somebody's arms. What's the imprint that the soul has carried? Now for the parents, where the child will be born, they'll say, my baby. To mera baby kaisa hona chahiye? Kaisa hona chahiye? So now that couple will read Life Positive magazine, Suma. They'll say, ha, soul on a journey. Once they close the magazine, they'll say, my baby. Have to translate it, my baby, but I don't know what that baby has experienced and come. Now they won't know why this baby is not happy. Why this baby is clinging on to family. Why is he not smart and confident like other siblings? Ye itna dara hua kyun rehta hai? Ye itna logon se kyun darta hai? They will not know. Because we do not take our spiritual knowledge into our practical life. We say, my child should be happy. I'm doing so much for him. Why is he not happy? Every soul is carrying so much baggage. So much baggage. How many people left the body at the airport last week? What was the last impression? All the people who survive a tragedy. Now this 8-year-old son will have to go through so much counseling, no? Because he's seen trauma. So the people who survive a tragedy, they get counseling. The people who leave the body in a tragedy don't get counseling. Because they're born in someone's house and the parents expect them to be new baby. To new baby kaisa hona chahiye? Then we can't understand why my child is like this, why my child is hyper, why my child is aggressive, why my child is sensitive. Not my child, soul on the journey. Similarly, everyone around us is carrying so much baggage. We have no idea what the past of that soul has been. We are only seeing people in this costume. So we look at their life and say, kya hua hai inki jeevan mein? Why are they not happy? We are carrying so much. Now, what would be the role of the parents in the new family now for this child? What can they do for that child? What can they do? No amount of toys. No amount of toys, no amount of facilities can heal that wound which that soul is carrying. Only love and affection and support. But if the child, if the parents create anxiety seeing the child like this, this child could turn out to be a very aggressive child also. We don't know how that child is going to take that trauma. It could be a very aggressive retaliation or could be very withdrawn, not connecting to people. Something which would not be what you would want a normal child to be. But if now parents create anxiety looking at their child, what will they radiate? Look at, just imagine, the child is there, the child needs love, support. I am the mother, I'm creating anxiety. So what am I radiating? I'm creating fear. Mere bacche ka kya hoga aage? What am I radiating? I'm sometimes criticizing him. Tum sab bachcho ke jaise kyun nahi ho? क्यों इतने डरते हो? आई ऑल्सो कंपेयर माई चाइल्ड विद समवन. उसको देखो वो कितना स्मार्ट है, तुम ऐसे कैसे हो? वॉट एम आई रेडिएटिंग? सो वॉट एज पेरेंट वॉट विल वी रेडिएट टू दैट चाइल्ड? Fear, anxiety, doubt of the future. What was the need for the child? We actually radiate the opposite of what the soul needs. So if the soul came into our family with, let's say, 30% battery, we could easily take them up to 80%. But with our fears and anxiety, we are going to make the 30%. This is our role. Our role is to empower souls, not to do things for each other. चीजें करने से खुशी नहीं होने वाली है सिर्फ. Important is what I am creating and what I am radiating. Now look at every soul around you. Every soul, not necessarily children, just everyone around you. And start looking at them as soul on the journey. Don't know what they've seen. Not just one lifetime, but how many recordings would be there over here? How many recordings would be there over here? That's why every philosopher and saint has said, once you know the answer of who am I, life will change. Who am I means soul on the journey, carrying so many recordings, accepting people will become, easy. There will be no question marks, why is this person like this? If now this soul carries sanskar of aggression or anxiety, friends and family and parents will say, why is this child like this? If someone then reminds them, you know, this soul is that soul, they'll say, ah, then it's okay, he's carrying this aggression. That's why people go and get past life regression done. Just to find out the cause for what is happening today. But we don't need to get it done. We just know that there was a cause. And that's why we are like this today. So past life regression is done just so that if I know the cause, I can accept the consequence of that cause today. Because whatever is happening today is a consequence of that past. Everything that's happening in our life today is a consequence of that past karma. So the best thing that we can do to empower ourselves is not to question the present. When we question the present scene or we question the other person, why is this like this? What are we radiating? Aap aise kyun hai? Why are we, what are we radiating? So meaning rejection. The minute I reject, I radiate this non-acceptance. When I'm rejecting someone or something, I'm depleting soul power. Am I depleting soul power? I'm depleting my power also, and I'm depleting the power of the other person. And when I accept the scene, what am I doing? When I accept the scene and the person, what am I doing? I'm empowering myself and I'm empowering the other person. What a big gift. Kitni badi gift hum de rahe hain. Now look at people around you and just subtle checking. किस किस को हम क्वेश्चन कर रहे हैं आज अंदर? ये ऐसा क्यों, ये ऐसा क्यों, ये ऐसा क्यों, ये ऐसा क्यों? वी कैन इवन सिट अक्रॉस द टीवी स्क्रीन क्वेश्चनिंग पीपल. वन डे इंडिया डजंट प्ले वेल, फॉर द नेक्स्ट 4 days 100 crore पीपल आर क्वेश्चनिंग देम. दोज नेक्स्ट 4 days कुड हैव बीन स्पेंट रेडिएटिंग power and blessings to them instead, right? In a country like India, it's very risky. One thing you do, 100 crore people radiate vibrations to you for that. Imagine if you, one soul, receives vibration from even 1 million people, what would it do to you? Just think, you're one person and 1 million people are sending negative energy to you. Today, if two people send negative energy to you, you'll go like this. See what we do as a country. What should we all be sending them? This is what we can do for each other. We sit across the TV screen, we're criticizing the cricketers, we're criticizing the politicians, we're criticizing anyone who doesn't perform the way we want them to do. Of course. Yes. Imagine what it would do. Imagine what it would do if even 10% of our country sends positive vibration tomorrow. You know what everyone's saying already? Australia ke against to bahut mushkil hai. India kabhi jeetta hi nahi hai. We talk about positive thinking and then what do we radiate? We talk about collective consciousness. We have the power to create miracles because collective consciousness in a country of this huge population can create miracles. But collective consciousness of another quality will also create another miracle. So if all of us had to create that thought, the team wouldn't know why they are playing so well. Power, vibrations. No, imagine so many people just sending blessings. Why is there a concept of blessings? This is the meaning of blessings. Why do we go to elders? Why do we go to saints and we say Ashirvad do? Why? People travel all the way and go to a saint, meet them for 1 minute. Say Ashirvad do. Why? What is the power in that? Kya hoga usse? You're just going to someone who's going to give you. Sabse zyada ashirvad hame kaun de sakta hai? Sabse zyada ashirvad hame kaun de sakta hai? Socho. Sabse zyada ashirvad hame kaun de sakta hai? Khud apne aap ko roz ashirvad do. Creating pure, powerful thoughts without even a micro thought of doubt in that. Hoga ki nahi hoga. That is a blessing. So why do I always need to go to somebody else? I may not always be able to travel in somewhere else and get blessings. My parents may not be with me anymore, so I will not get their blessings. But there's one person who can bless me always. Sometimes, even if we're receiving the blessings of everyone, it doesn't work on us. Because we are, what can a blessing do? Suppose you have an exam tomorrow and I say, I'm 100% sure you'll do very well tomorrow. So what am I just radiating? I'm radiating a very powerful thought. What power does my thought have? My thought can influence your thought process. Okay? My thought can influence your thought process. But your thought is still going to be your thought. If you allow my thought to influence your thought process, then you can use my powerful thought to create a powerful thought. So I will say, I'm 100% sure you're going to do very well tomorrow. So you use that ashirvad and you create a thought. I'm 100% sure I'll do very well. So my ashirvad works for you. But actually, who's done the work? Who's done the work? You yourself. So we have to be clear of the power that we have. Because what we say, unhone ashirvad diya na to kaam ho gaya. Then every day we want to go to them for the ashirvad. No, no dependency on anybody. Unhone ashirvad diya, lekin unka ashirvad lekar, aapne wo powerful thought create ki, tab aapka kaam ho gaya. Right? The other way. Maine ashirvad diya, ki tomorrow you'll do very well. Is there a possibility you don't get influenced by that thought? So what will you keep saying to yourself? Mere se nahi hone wala. Everyone will say to you, you'll do very well, you'll do very well. So you're getting lot of ashirvad. But your mind doesn't use that ashirvad to convert your thinking to positivity. Ashirvad did not work for you. And you continue saying, no, I'm not going to do well, no, I'm not going to do well. And finally you don't do well. So positive energy of other people can influence us, but it cannot create our positive thoughts. That choice is still with us. The other way around, I create a thought, you won't do well tomorrow. आजकल लोगों के पास एक नया कॉन्सेप्ट आया दुनिया में है, कुछ भी होता है ना थोड़ा सा, कहते किसी की नजर लग गई है, होता है ना, कुछ भी हुआ, कोई बीमार हुआ नजर लग गई, ये हुआ नजर लग गई, किसी की नजर लग गई, समवन इज जेलस ऑफ मी, सम ईवल आई, किसी की नजर लगी, कैसे लगी, मींस आई क्रिएटेड अ नेगेटिव थॉट फॉर यू, देन उसके बाद यू हैव द पावर वेदर यू आर गोइंग टू अलाउ दैट नेगेटिव थॉट टू इन्फ्लुएंस यू. अगर द होल वर्ल्ड ऑल्सो क्रिएट्स नेगेटिव एनर्जी फॉर यू, बट इफ यू आर वेरी स्ट्रांग, इट विल नॉट अफेक्ट यू. द होल वर्ल्ड क्रिएट्स पॉजिटिव थॉट्स फॉर यू, बट यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू क्रिएट, इट विल नॉट अफेक्ट यू. अदर पीपल्स वाइब्रेशंस कैन इन्फ्लुएंस अस, दे के नॉट चेंज आर डेस्टिनी. Our destiny is created only by the way we think. Jitna hum kahenge kisi ki nazar lagi, we have started creating thoughts of fear and anxiety. We allow that negative energy to influence us and we make that a reality. Suppose I create a thought from here, you should fall off that chair. Why are you getting scared? As if you will fall just because I create a thought. Can you fall? Suppose I create a thought from you should fall. No, people are really creating fear and panic today. Unki wajah se mera business kharab ho gaya. Unki wajah se mere rishte kharab ho gaye. So I'll just create a simple thought. She should fall off the chair. Will she fall? Because the more we are creating fear and panic, the more there's an entire industry out there exploiting our fear and panic. फिर ये कर लो एंड सारी नजर से बच जाएंगे. एंड द मोर वी यूज दैट द मोर फियर एंड पैनिक. इफ आई क्रिएट अ थॉट यू शुड फॉल ऑफ द चेयर, विल यू फॉल? यस और नो? नो. इफ वी ऑल टुगेदर क्रिएट अ थॉट दैट शी शुड फॉल ऑफ द चेयर, विल शी फॉल? If we all create a thought, she should fall, will she fall?
No.
The minute she creates a thought that everyone is thinking that I should fall, so suppose I fall, then she'll fall. But when she falls, she will not take the responsibility of having created that thought. She will say, I fell because everyone else was thinking that I should fall. This is where we give up personal responsibility. And we say whatever is happening is because of. तो कुछ बुरा हुआ तो किसी की नजर लगी, कुछ अच्छा हुआ तो किसी का आशीर्वाद लगा, मेरा कुछ नहीं है इसमें. Then if I'm not aware of my own power and potential, how will I use my power and potential? How will I do it? तो आशीर्वाद लेना तो अच्छी बात है, लेकिन आशीर्वाद भी क्या लेना चाहिए जाके? क्या आशीर्वाद लेना चाहिए? What ashirvad do we want? For strength. Yeah. हम जाते हैं संत महात्माओं के पास, उनको कहते हैं महात्मा जी आशीर्वाद दे दो मेरा काम हो जाए. तो भगवान के सामने भी खड़े होते हैं, भगवान जी मेरा काम हो जाए. They can give us the power, the purity, which we can use here to create that power and purity, which then we can use to get the work done. The equation has to be very clear. Even God's power I can use to increase soul power, and then I'll use the soul power to get my work done. I cannot say please get that work done. No. We also need to know the role of that supreme power. What can he do? What can he not do? Can God give us a nice car? See, this is the thing. God can do anything. Can God give me a nice car? Can God give me a nice car? Go tomorrow morning, start praying every day. Bhagwan ji, Mercedes chahiye ya kaun si, jo si bhi chahiye. रोज उसको जाके बोलो गाड़ी चाहिए गाड़ी चाहिए गाड़ी चाहिए, दे सकता है? He can empower me to buy the car. So when I go up to him, what should I be taking? Power, not car. दो चीजों में तो फर्क है ना, दो चीजों में फर्क है. Why can God not give me a car? Very good, simple. है ही नहीं उनके पास, कैसे देंगे? This is what it is. है ही नहीं उनके पास. It's like the sun. It's so powerful. It's the sun's light and power which is energizing the world every day. But can that sun give me a car? No. It can charge the world every day, but it can't give me a car because it doesn't have a car. So what does God have? Bhagwan ke paas kya hai? Ocean of love, ocean of purity, ocean of knowledge, ocean of peace, not Mercedes showroom. No. No, but I can take that power, empower myself, work very hard, buy the car. Perfect. Equation has to be clear. लेकिन हम उनके सामने खड़े होके कहे मेरे को कार दे दो, मुझे नौकरी दिला दो, मुझे एग्जाम में पास करा दो, मेरे बच्चे की शादी करा दो. फिर हमें कोई आके कहता है वहां जाओ, वहां जाओगे तो हो जाएगा, तो हम वहां चले जाते हैं. कहीं भी जाना, तीर्थ स्थान पे जाना, संत महात्माओं के पास जाना, किस लिए जाना? पावर लेने के लिए जाना, काम करवाने के लिए जाना नहीं. वो तो बिजनेस हो गया. फिर उसमें से इंटेंशन एंड प्योरिटी ऑफ आर इंटेंशन ऑल्सो डिसअपियर्स बिकॉज इट्स मोर अ डील. ये मेरा काम हो जाएगा तो हम ये कर देंगे. कितने डील तो आज भगवान के साथ हो जाती है, होती है नहीं होती? ये मेरा काम कर दो तब मैं वैष्णो देवी जाऊं. तो काम हो जाएगा तो जाएंगे, नहीं होगा तो नहीं जाएंगे. अच्छा, होने के बाद भी जाना भूल जाते हैं या पोस्टपोन हो जाता है, थोड़ा सा कुछ काम आ जाता है, फिर बीच में जीवन में कुछ प्रॉब्लम आने लगती. कहते गए नहीं ना वैष्णो देवी, सी वी डिडंट फुलफिल आर पार्ट ऑफ द डील, टुमारो बुक द टिकट एंड गो, काम हो जाएगा. गॉड्स रूल, गॉड इज नॉट क्रिएटिंग दीज प्रॉब्लम्स एंड ऑब्स्टिकल्स इन आवर लाइफ. दीज ऑल आर अ कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ consequence of my past karma. Now when that past karma is come before me, I'll take his power, knowledge, empower myself, face the consequence. But if I don't empower myself and I say please kaam kar do, it will not happen. Just the right equation, who is the one who has to do it? What is my power? What is his power? What I can take from him and how I can use it? Every scene that is coming in my life, who's responsible for it? Who's responsible for it? It's a consequence of my past. Can I afford to blame anyone for it? The worst scene today, can I blame anyone for it? Can I blame? And look at how many times we are blaming people the whole day. And blaming means depleting soul power. If I blame you for what's happening in my life, then I'm not taking the responsibility of rectifying it. I say it's because of you. One brother was sharing with me the other day. He said, I woke up one morning and just this table was lying next, this table was just next to my bed. And when I got down like this, I hit the table. So he said, I started shouting, who kept the table here? Ye, wo, wo, meko chot lag gayi, meko dard ho raha hai. Somebody dheere se aaye aur kaan mein kaha, aapne rakhi thi kal raat ko. Now the minute you come to know ke aapne rakhi thi kal raat ko, what will happen? The blaming is over. Kyunki maine rakhi thi kal raat ko. Shouting at other people, over. Personal responsibility. मैंने रखी थी कल रात को. नाउ चॉइस, अब चॉइस. कल तो रखी थी मैंने, अब क्या करना है? अब क्या करना है? आज ठीक से रख देना है. हम क्या करते हैं? ब्लेम कर देते हैं, चिल्ला देते हैं और उठा के उसको ठीक से नहीं रखते, अगले दिन फिर चोट लगती है. एवरी सीन, नाउ लुक एट एब्सोल्युटली एवरी सीन कमिंग इन योर लाइफ. whether it's health, whether it's relationship, whether it's work, it's a consequence of my past thought and karma. That past could be in this costume. That past could be in any other dress. How does that matter? It's my responsibility. And who's going to change it? My health is a consequence of my choices. And if I want to do something about it, who's going to change it? Me. Any healing therapy that we go for today, what are they taking us? Past, what are you holding? Remove, delete it, any emotional blockage, remove it. Ye kar doge, body will get healed. So that means who created the disease? Who created the disease? I. Who will heal it? I. Power of my thought. Every thought I create, just look at every thought I create, what power does it have? One thought I create, first, where does it influence my thought? Every thought, if I enter into this room and I say, what a beautiful hall, it's a thought. The first thing to get influenced will be myself. That means if I create a thought, what a beautiful hall, I feel nice. And which means how I feel will be dependent on what I created. So my thought will first influence how I feel, one. Second, behavior. My thought, feeling, my thought, using God's energy to cleanse any negativity in that food and purifying that food, now I will eat. Finished. Water, see, aise le liya, aise pi liya. I don't know what vibrations this water is carrying. 30 seconds, pause. This water will become Amrit. What is Amrit that we go and take like this in the temple? What is the difference between this water and that water? That water was charged, na? Charged by someone. Why can't we do it? Why can't we do it? So that our every glass of water will be Amrit. My every plate of food will be Prasad. Then I don't need to worry, kab, kaha, kya vibration hai usme. Then everything that I will be taking inside will be energized. Power of my thought. Same power I can use while cooking the food. So then we can cook prasad for everyone at home. So even if somebody at home is stressed, I can cook peace and feed it to them. But if I tell them, pizza order kar lo. The more our children today are eating out, the more they are connecting to money and less to family. Because they are eating food cooked with the intention of earning money. Why was it said that the way to a man's heart is through his? What is the meaning of that line? That if you cook for that man, his vibration will get connected to your vibration. So if we cook for our children, they will get connected to the mother, otherwise they get connected to money. So then family becomes second priority, money becomes first priority. So healing my mind, my body, my food, my water, my relationships, heal the world. Who will create that new world? We are going to create it. So simple. We created Kaliyug and now we are going to create Satyug. Nobody else is going to do it for us. Should we heal that relationship for 2 minutes, right? Sit back, comfortable. Has affected my feeling. Second, my thought will influence my body. My thought will immediately radiate to my body. Today medical science is saying every thought affects every cell of the body. So my thought first affecting how I feel and behave, then influencing my body. Third, my thought will radiate to the person for whom it was created. So my relationship, and fourth, my thought will radiate into the universe, so the quality of my world. my every thought. अभी देखो सारा दिन हम क्या क्या सोचते हैं, कितना ध्यान से सोचना पड़ेगा, कितना ध्यान से सोचना पड़ेगा, because my every thought is influencing how I feel and behave, is influencing my health, my relationships and my world. If we are going to create a new world, where is it going to start from? It's from my thoughts. So can I afford to go on with my old way of thinking, woh thoda sa irritation, woh hurt, woh pattern, woh depression, woh anger? New world kaise aayega? New world kaise aayega? Huh? Stop thinking to hota nahi. Change thinking hota hai. We can't stop thinking. No one can stop thinking. We can slow down thinking. We can't stop thinking. And to slow down thinking, change the quality. When you're thinking pure thoughts, it'll be slow. When it's anxiety, fear, very fast. The quality pe work kar lo, quantity to apne aap kam ho jayegi. Now, who is the creator of my thoughts? I. Based on what basis will my thoughts get created? Past experiences, one. Second, belief system, what else?
Desire.
My information that I take in every day. My information that I take in every day and my sanskars that I have created. When we are talking about creating a new world, a healthy body, a beautiful relationship, we are talking about changing our sanskars. Medical science used to earlier tell us it's all in the gene, it's in the DNA, it can't be changed. Spirituality said every sanskar can be changed. Can we change our sanskars? Can we change our sanskars? Kya karna hoga? Can you select one sanskar today which you would like to change? Apna, dusron ka nahi. Dusron ka bahut easy hai select karna. Apna. Select. Okay. Okay. What else? Criticism. Anger. Now, give this the replacement sanskar. We know what we want to remove, but we're going to replace it with something. So put the replacement word. क्या होगा? क्रिटिसिज्म की जगह क्या होगा? एक्सेप्टेंस एंड अप्रिसिएशन, वन. स्ट्रेस की जगह क्या होगा? पेशेंस, पेशेंस, टॉलरेंस. एंगर की जगह क्या होगा? लव. और एनीबडी एल्स वांट्स टू सिलेक्ट एनी वन संस्कार? रिएक्शन की जगह रिस्पॉन्ड. और अब, now we've selected which one we want to do. Now how will we do it? How will we bring it into action? कैसे करेंगे? Select हो गया. अब कैसे करेंगे? Awareness. Sanskar. How does a sanskar get created? Simple, right? Suppose I have a sanskar of criticism. How did it happen? एक बार किया, दो बार किया, पांच बार किया, दस बार किया, हो गया. Now that pattern of having done it 10 times and making it into a habit may have happened in this lifetime or may have happened somewhere before when I'm not aware. Okay, it could have happened sometime. But it happened only in this way, that I did something 10 to 15 times, it became my habit. When it happens in an earlier lifetime and we carry that sanskar, we are not even aware when we made it a habit. And we think this is my nature. हम कहते हैं ये मेरी nature है, ये इनकी nature है. उसको nature नहीं बोलना चाहिए, उनको कहते हैं ये इनकी आदत है. Nature बोलते हैं ना, इसलिए कि change नहीं हो सकती. आदत बोलेंगे ना, change हो सकती है. Many people will say, don't tell me to change. This is my nature. Which means, this is my habit. And any habit is only a pattern, and any pattern can be changed. Suppose you go to work today, new place, first time. Aluvalyaji, new office. Your pune comes to you in the morning, your office boy. And he comes to you on the first day morning, 9 o'clock, says, what would you like to have? Tea, coffee, nariyal pani, so many options are there. Suppose that morning you select tea. So that day, first time, we took a decision and we chose tea. The mind, that is the staff member, had come with all options. Tea, coffee, herbal tea, green tea, nariyal pani, lassi, so many options. That's the mind. The buddhi, the intellect, that day said, tea. First time I did the karma of drinking tea. Impression recorded. Next day, 9 o'clock, the office boy will again give you options. Sir, tea, coffee. Second day, if the intellect again says tea. Second day, again karma, recording tea. Kitne din puchhega? Kitne din puchhega, wo ladka? Do char din, teen char din, ha na? Teen char din? Thik hai. Agar usne teen char din se zyada pucha, to aap kya kahenge? Malum nahi hai kya? Bar bar roz aake puchta hai. This is the mind, the intellect and the karma. The mind is the one which gives options. Chhoot bolu, nahi bolu. Gussa karu, nahi karu. Bribe karu, nahi karu. This is the mind. It always gave options first time. Do bar, char bar, panch bar. If the intellect says, panche bar ke baad, it has gone into the automatic mode, which means every day at 9 o'clock now he will bring tea without asking. Right? So we've shifted from the option mode to an automatic way of living. Forever. This boy will now bring tea at 9 o'clock in the morning. And your sanskar becomes of drinking tea. Now, the soul leaves the body. Takes another body. What sanskar has the soul carried? Tea. तो अलग अलग बच्चे, ये बच्चे को ये नहीं अच्छा लगता, वो बच्चे को वो नहीं अच्छा लगता. While the soul is in the womb of the mother, mother feels like drinking tea even if she's never had it before, because the soul in the womb needs tea. This is where we are carrying the sanskar. Now the child, new costume, carrying the habit of drinking tea. Now this can go on for one life, and this sanskar can go on for many, many lives, till one day the soul says, I want to change this sanskar. Right? So suppose today somebody tells you, tea is not good for you. Itne nuksan. Tomorrow morning when you go to work, you'll have to tell that boy, chai nahi pini. So that boy will again have to give you options. So we will shift from the automatic way of living again to the conscious awareness option way of living. So he'll again bring a whole list for you. That day you will choose a healthier option. Kya choose karenge us din? Green tea. Okay. So us din aapne kaha green tea. First time after many years or probably many lives you are changing a pattern. So that day green tea. Mind and the body will not take it immediately. Even that office boy will be surprised. Sir, chai nahi pini aapko aaj? Kaise chai nahi pini? Pilo, pilo, sir dard hoega. Aaspaas ke log bhi bolenge, chai pilo. Whenever we want to change a sanskar, in Kaliyug, lot of people will give us different advice. Just now before the session, I met a sister. I don't know whether she's in the hall. She said, when we start on this journey, people around us make fun of us. I said, why? The people say, aise kaise you're forgiving people? Aise kaise you can be like this? So when we change our sanskars, we are not necessarily going to get appreciation from people around us. Because in Kaliyug, your Satyug sanskar might not be acceptable to other people. Kaliyug means he did this to you, you do twice back. Satyug means he did this to you, accept, forgive, move on. People around you are going to say, pagal hai kya? Aisa kaun karta hai? So you might get ridiculed, you might get rejection. It's okay, we are changing our habit. So the first time we think of changing a sanskar, there will be... So you'll have to stick to your green tea. Stick to the green tea. How many days? How many days? जब पहली बार तीन चार दिन लगे तो दूसरी बार भी कितने दिन लगेंगे तीन चार दिन ही लगेंगे After that, forever and for many lifetimes, it is going to be healthy संस्कार कितना easy है कितना easy है But we can continue with our संस्कार्स without changing. Now let's select that संस्कार whether it's stress, whether it's anger, whether it's criticism, any habit. Healthier option, kaun sa choose kiya? Acceptance, appreciation. Now, the next time the stimulus comes, the situation comes, we will have to be aware. This is where awareness comes. Awareness is needed just for few days to change that sanskar. After that, that sanskar will go into the automatic mode. Then you are going to say, I don't know, mujhe sab log itne achhe kyun lagte hain? It will go into the automatic mode. Will it not go? Negative sanskars don't go into automatic mode. Every sanskar goes into automatic mode, no? It's only that shifting from this one to the other one. Kaise karenge abhi a shift? How will we do it? How will we do it? First, every morning, meditation, we will visualize ourselves having green tea today. We will need to prepare the mind, the brain, the body, everything for the new sanskar today. We will create that thought today. I am a soul who appreciates and accepts everyone. Because I understand that every soul has been on a long journey. It's not I will be like this. I am like this. I am. The mind is listening. Just tell the mind who you are. Say, I am like that. I am a very appreciative soul. I appreciate everyone. Sun raha hai. Jab humne subah ye kar diya. Ab jisko gusse ka sanskar khatam karna hai. I'm a very peaceful and loveful soul. We will never say, I want to become like that. No, I am. Because every thought we create, every thought we create, here, here and here. So I am, not I am going to become, I am. If I say I will want to become like that, which means abhi main kaun hu? I am an angry soul wanting to be peaceful. I am an angry soul. I am a peaceful soul, I am a loveful soul, and which is the truth but forgotten. Morning 5 minutes. 5 minutes. Meditation, giving that message to the mind and the body, seeing yourself doing it in those situations and people where earlier we would use another sanskar. There are certain scenes in which we use that sanskar. There are certain people whom we criticize. There are certain times when we get angry. See ourselves responding to those in a different way. Mind is watching. I just read a very interesting study a few days back. This was done by some professors and doctors of Harvard. They took two groups of people. This group of people was supposed to play the piano 5 days, 2 hours every day. 5 days, 2 hours every day, play the piano. This group of people was supposed to, in their mind, play the piano. 5 days, 2 hours every day. Physically, just mentally. And every day they were seeing what is the brain pattern, how is it changing. It was the same for both the groups. And the study said, the brain and the body cannot differentiate between the real and the imaginary. And it says, this science can be used to understand how we create a disease and it can also be used to heal the body. Now, visualizing, playing the piano with the mind, Now what will we do with the mind? I am a peaceful soul. I am a divine soul. Today they will come to me and I will be talking to them very peacefully, very politely, very sweetly. I'll appreciate the brain and the body and everybody's listening. It's getting recorded. Once this is meditation, and then when that scene actually comes, how will we respond? It will automatically happen. And then not just do it 5 minutes in the morning, every hour, 2 hours, 1 minute quick revision. 1 minute quick revision, programming hoti jayegi. When the actual scene comes before, we'll perform it a different way. How do actors rehearse their part before a play? Actors rehearse their part. We should also rehearse our part before the scene, no? We just go into every scene unprepared. And then we are focused more on the other people's script and their dialogues and how they should be behaving. Apna to. Jitna awareness utna ho jayega. So when we go into this scene, do you think we will do it a different way? Will we do it a different way? No, not hopefully. The mind is listening. That is what we are changing. The minute I say to my mind, hopefully you will be able to do it. It's like, see, another child, tell your child, try karo, hopefully you will be able to do it. Chances? What do you want? You want the child to be able to do it. So what will you say? I'm sure you'll do it. Same here. Chota sa bachcha to yahan baitha hai na. Iske upar humne give up hi kar diya. Hopefully karke dekho kya hota hai. Kartna bar to kiya hota to hai nahi. We demotivate ourselves. So will we be able to do it? 100%. This same technique is used for healing the soul, healing the body, healing any relationship, healing the world. Create that thought, visualize it and radiate it. It will happen. What is every healing therapy telling us today? You have a disease in the body? What happens? The disease got created because of some wrong thinking. Now, once I get that disease, what thoughts do I start creating? What thoughts do I start creating? Main bimar hu. Main bimar hu. Main bimar hu. Mujhe diabetes hai, mujhe diabetes hai. The body is listening. So what will the body do? What will the body do? Wo hai, wo kahega, haan hai, haan hai, haan hai. Now use that theory. That the real, the brain and the body cannot differentiate between the real and the imaginary. Now you want that disease to disappear. So what do you want to do? That's what every healing therapy is telling us to do. Create a thought, wo blockage hai. Create a thought, blockage is gone. My artery is absolutely clean. My blood pressure is normal. My cholesterol is normal. Say it every day. The brain and the body cannot differentiate. It will do it. Hum kya kehte hain roz? I have high BP. I have high cholesterol. I have this. I have backache. Back is listening. It pains every day. Whatever we create, it will radiate, it will manifest. So every healing therapy is now teaching us, create a thought that I'm perfectly healthy. Wo jo cheez thi, wo puri tarah se khatam ho gayi hai, gayab ho gayi hai. The body will respond. Medical science will be able to heal my physical body with medicines. But who's creating the illness? Not remove the disease from the soul. So after some time there is a possibility the disease will come back. I removed the top layer. So let medical science cure the physical body and let my mind cure the energy body and the soul. I can do that. Now, with the relationship, what can we do with the thought power? Suppose there is some conflict in any relationship, what can we do? किसी के साथ रिश्ता उतना अच्छा नहीं है जितना होना चाहिए. What can we do? See the kind of thoughts that we create. What will those kind of thoughts do? What will those kind of thoughts do? वो ऐसे क्यों हैं? वो ऐसे क्यों करते हैं? आज भी उन्होंने ऐसा किया, बार बार ऐसा करते हैं, कहना नहीं मानते, अच्छा नहीं हो रहा, विश्वास नहीं करते, respect. What will all these thoughts do to the relationship? बीमारी और बढ़ती जाएगी. We want the relationship to be healed. क्या thought create करेंगे? Positive vibration तो ठीक है, but what will have to be that vibration? What should be the thought? Not really bad, नहीं. Not really bad मतलब क्या? See, every thought we'll have to be so careful because it's reaching and it's manifesting. That's all that we need to take care of. Change our vocabulary a little bit. यहाँ थोड़ा सा change चाहिए सिर्फ. Everything will change outside. If I say you're not really bad, which means you're thoda bad, not very bad, that will radiate. Say you're a beautiful soul. You're a beautiful soul. My relationship with you is excellent. Even if there is something which we are carrying of the past, it's past. The present is in my hand today. Let me change. Why is there a conflict in my relationship today? Because of something that we've done before? Why is someone behaving with me the way they are doing today? Because of something that I've done? So it's my consequence. I created what is today. Now I have the power to change it. Now I have the power to change it. Like we can heal the body, can we heal the relationship? We've all heard of pranic healing. We've all heard of Reiki. People can sit at a distance and heal somebody. Yes? If you can sit at a distance and heal someone's disease, can you sit at a distance and heal another soul? If I can sit focused energy from here and heal a disease in your body, can I send focused energy from here and heal a pain in the soul? Can we do that? That's all that we need to do. Do we do that? You have to send. You keep sending, and if you want the success rate to be a little higher, send it at a time when they're sleeping. If you send me energy when I'm sleeping, my conscious mind is silent. Vibrations I will catch easier. When my conscious mind wakes up, my phone is engaged. You understand? I'm thinking too much, so I might not catch your thoughts. But when my phone is silent, I'm not talking to anyone in my mind. And that's why early morning, when other people are sleeping, best time. Hit them. They won't know why they're feeling nice when they wake up. Yes, any time when the other person is sleeping. But early morning is always good for early good energy. Why early morning? In the night, the vibrations of the environment. Night mein saare galat kaam ho rahe You have all sorts of things everywhere happening around you in the night. So the vibrations of the environment will not be in sync with what you're trying to send. But if you do it early morning, then the vibrations. So that's the best time to sow your seed. You can sow it any time. You can sow those vibrations any time. But when you're doing focused healing, let's do it at the time when it's the best time. Night means there is everything possible happening everywhere. Collective consciousness vibrations is a very powerful thing. Very powerful. Where we live, we breathe that air. If we are in Delhi, we're breathing that air. If we are in Delhi, we're also consuming the vibrations of the city. So, let's do it at a time when. That's why we say Amrit Vela, Brahmotsav, 4 a.m., 5 a.m., when people are sleeping. People who wake up at 5 a.m. are also sleeping. People who sleep at that time are also sleeping. There are some people who sleep at 4 o'clock nowadays. So that's why we say Amrit Vela 4 o'clock, because 4 o'clock is the time when maximum people are sleeping. जो सोने वाले हैं वो भी सो रहे हैं, जिन्होंने अभी उठना है वो भी सो रहे हैं. दैट्स द टाइम व्हेन मैक्सिमम पीपल आर स्लीपिंग, वाइब्रेशंस ऑफ द एनवायरनमेंट विल बी, व्हिच मींस योर इंटरनेट कनेक्शन एट दैट टाइम विल बी, नो वन्स देयर ऑन द नेटवर्क, योर हाईवे इज क्लियर, नाउ सेंड व्हाट यू वांट टू सेंड, इट विल गो एंड हिट द अदर पर्सन. डेली, लेट्स डू इट डेली. गेट अप इन द मॉर्निंग, sit in our meditation, immerse that soul, use God's power, send it to them. Speaking and doing cannot make people happy. But if we send these focused vibrations to them every day, our thoughts, we can use it to heal ourselves, we can use it to heal our body, we can use it to heal our relationship, we can use it to heal the world. We can use it to purify our food, we can use it to purify our water. हम खाना सामने आता है, हम ऐसे ही खा लेते हैं, ऐसे नहीं खाना चाहिए उसको, ऐसे नहीं खाना चाहिए कभी भी. हमें नहीं मालूम है किस मन की स्थिति से वो खाना बनाया गया. अभी आप लंच कर रहे थे यहाँ पे, आपको मालूम है किसने बनाया वो खाना? क्या आपको मालूम है किसने बनाया वो खाना? नहीं मालूम है. तो आपको ये नहीं मालूम है कि बनाने वाले की मन की स्थिति क्या थी. सपोज मैंने बनाया वो खाना, एंड सपोज आई एम टेंस्ड अबाउट समथिंग, ओके, आई एम अपसेट एंड आई एम टेंस्ड अबाउट समथिंग, सो व्हाइल आई एम कुकिंग फॉर यू माय वाइब्रेशंस ऑफ स्ट्रेस विल गो इनटू द फूड. राइट नाउ यू आर मूविंग ऑन अ जर्नी व्हेन यू वांट टू क्लेंज योर स्ट्रेस. But now you're eating food which has been cooked by me in a stressful state of mind. जैसा अन्न वैसा मन. तो आप अपने स्ट्रेस की तो सफाई कर रहे हैं, लेकिन आपने हाथ तो मेरे हाथ का बना हुआ खाना खा लिया, और मेरी स्थिति में बहुत स्ट्रेस था. So you cannot check my state of mind, but what you can do is when that food is there before you, purify that food before eating it. कैसे करोगे आप? इसमें स्ट्रेस की वाइब्रेशन आ गई. नाउ व्हाट कैन यू डू? व्हाट कैन यू डू? कनेक्ट टू गॉड. गॉड इज द ओशन ऑफ पीस एंड पावर. दैट वाइब्रेशन इज गोइंग इन ऑल दिस फूड. इसका कण कण क्या होता जा रहा है? प्योरिफाई, क्लेंस, पावरफुल. नाउ दिस फूड इज प्रसाद फॉर यू. व्हाट इज प्रसाद विच वी गेट इन द टेम्पल? फूड विच हैज बीन एनर्जाइज्ड विद द वाइब्रेशंस ऑफ. तो एवरी टाइम प्रसाद खा सकते हैं ना? एवरी टाइम प्रसाद खा सकते हैं ना? बाय टेकिंग अप. व्हाई वी वर टॉट के व्हेन द फूड कम्स बिफोर यू पहले क्या करना है? इट इज साइंटिफिक. एवरीथिंग दैट वी वर टॉक वाज सो साइंटिफिक, बट वी वर डूइंग इट विदाउट अंडरस्टैंडिंग. तो व्हाट वी वुड से, हाँ थैंक यू गॉड फॉर द फूड, एंड वी स्टार्ट ईटिंग. मींस आई कैन नॉट मेक यू हैप्पी एंड यू कैन नॉट मेक मी हैप्पी. 100%. I can do something for you, you can do something for me, is fine. But that does not mean that I can make you happy and you can make me happy. No, I can do something for you. Doing things for people, yes, we can do a lot for people. But there's no guarantee. Because if you do it with the intention and understanding that I'm doing this to make them happy, and after doing everything, if you feel that they're still not happy, then that's going to become the cause of pain for us. And we will say, which is a very common line, इनके लिए इतना किया, इतना किया, इतना किया, ये अभी भी खुश नहीं है, तो हम दुखी हो जाते हैं. होता है ऐसा कभी कभी कि किसी के लिए कितना किया, कितना किया, कितना 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 किया, कितना किया, जीवन भर किया. Clarity. We need to have complete clarity कि हम क्या कर सकते हैं, क्या नहीं कर सकते हैं, तब हम दुखी नहीं होंगे. हम क्या कर सकते हैं, हम क्या नहीं कर सकते. What power do we have and what power do we not have? We have the power to do things for people. सुबह से रात तक आप अपने बच्चों के लिए कुछ कर सकते हैं. But it is not 100% necessary that they will be happy, because their being happy is dependent on how they feel. But my contribution towards others' happiness is not in what I do for them, is in me being a radiator of happiness. If I give you a very beautiful gift right now, it's not necessary you will be happy. But if I am radiating happiness, then the chances of you catching that vibration and using that vibration to feel better, chances are higher. Gift, if I give, you can use that gift. Suppose I give you a dress. So I give you the gift, you can use the dress. You can wear the gift, you can eat the gift, you can use the gift. But that gift cannot give you happiness. And suppose while buying the gift, I have created some kya lena abhi inke liye samajh nahi aa raha, kitna mushkil hai, kya lo, this time I don't even have that much budget, yet I have to buy, lekin dena to padega, unhone bhi diya tha, aa rahe hain, dena to hoga hi, then to my gift has come packaged with. Then my gift has come packaged with. This is what is happening in life. We are doing a lot of things for people, but sometimes the doing is packaged with.
Not necessarily always,
never. Now, yes, but when I genuinely buy something for you also, the happiness that you're receiving is not actually from the gift, it is, you're receiving it from those genuine vibrations that I'm radiating to you. The gift will be used by you. Do cheezon mein farak hai. One is physical. Let's say I gift you this bottle of water. I've genuinely bought it with lot of love. Okay? So with lot of love, searched for 2 hours in the market, bought it, spent a good amount of money. Now I gift you this bottle of water. What can this bottle of water give you? What can this give you? This can give you only water. This is water and it can give you water. You can feel happy because of the vibrations that I created in buying and giving you the gift. You can experience happiness because of the thought that you create, how sweet of her to get me a gift. That thought will give you happiness. This will not give happiness. Oh, important is to know the way to that happiness, because otherwise we are focused on buying more and more expensive gifts, thinking that the better the gift, more the happiness. No. More I do for people, the more happier they will be. No. Because happiness is not in the doing. Happiness is not in the act. Happiness is what I'm radiating while doing the act. The physical object will give you the physical comfort. Forget giving it to other people. What about for ourselves? We buy so many things for ourselves thinking that this will give me happiness. Can an object give me happiness? Can an object give me happiness? The new car, the new dress, the new phone. Temporary. Tell me, how much time it can give you happiness? New sari, chalo. Think. We think this is very simple, it's very important. What I'm wearing, what I'm using, can this give me happiness? Because we are buying all these things thinking it's good to buy them, but we have to be very clear, why are we buying them? We buy them thinking that this is going to give us happiness. Can a physical object give me happiness?
That's a
Very good. It has a utility value. You buy a new sari, what all is it going to give you?
You wear it.
Suppose I come up to and say, I say, aapne kya kharida? It's not looking nice on you at all. I'm very blunt, so I probably speak like that. I'll say, this color is not suiting you at all. Now. Your sari is still there? Your sari is still there? So if the sari was meant to give the happiness, then my criticism should not have affected it. If the sari was giving it to me, suppose I have lot of happiness and I go to the Mercedes showroom and I say, here's happiness, give me a car. Can happiness buy a car? Yes or no? Can happiness buy a car? No. What do I need to buy a car? I need money. Physical cheese lene ke liye, physical cheese chahiye. So happiness cannot buy a car. Certain? 100% certain? Happiness cannot buy a car. Car can buy happiness? Happiness cannot give you a car. Happiness cannot give you a car. Money can give you the car. Happiness cannot give you the car. Car can give you happiness? It's very important to know this. Think again, you're going to create the answer. I don't know the answer. Happiness cannot get you a car. Car can get you happiness? What can the car give me?
Comfort.
There's a difference. Everything physical, whether it's a car, whether it's a dress, whether it's my phone, whether it's whatever, everything physical will give me something physical. Everything physical will give me something physical. Happiness is not physical. So physical car, physical phone, physical watch, physical dress will give me physical comforts. We started using those physical objects as a symbol of... Why? Because when we used that physical object, we created a thought, I've bought a new car. I've bought that car which I've wanted. I've bought a car better than my so-and-so. It is that thought which is giving me happiness, not the car. The car is the stimulus that I use to create that nice thought. That nice thought makes me feel happy. The equation has to be very clear. I want to feel happy, so I want to create nice thoughts to feel happy. Now to create those nice thoughts, I use a stimulus. When you wore the new dress, someone complimenting that dress, so the dress was the stimulus. Had you not worn the new dress, you won't get those compliments. So you wear a new dress, you get nice words. First the dress is the stimulus, then those nice words are the stimulus. The dress got you the nice words. You used the nice words to create nice thoughts. So you felt nice. So you said dress is equal to happiness. Now the same dress got you criticism from me. So the dress is the stimulus. My harsh words are the stimulus. And now you will use my harsh words to go. Stimulus is the same. Creator is choosing what to create with that stimulus. Is the stimulus giving me the happiness? No. The same. Suppose you buy a diamond set today. Now, for a lot of people, diamonds will give happiness. Yes? Yes? Will the same diamonds give happiness to everyone? No. Why? Depending on the The same diamonds will give happiness to the wife, stress to the husband. The same diamonds will give me nothing because I don't wear them, so no use to me. If the diamond was able to radiate happiness, it would give happiness to everybody. Like a flower radiates fragrance. It's going to radiate fragrance to everyone. Does diamond radiate happiness? Does a car radiate happiness? Physical objects don't radiate vibrations. कार के पास खुशी है नहीं, देगा कैसे? खुशी किसके पास है? Physical objects all will give us physical comfort. They are जड़. खुशी नहीं है इसके पास. I take this new watch. I create a thought, then I feel happy. This cannot give me the happiness. To be very clear. Now I have the choice to create a nice thought after getting a watch or without buying the watch. The entire business, the entire advertising agency is using this one wrong belief system to make a lot of money. Every ad is showing you that when you buy this, you will be happy. So they are selling happiness and we are trying to buy it. And then they will come out with iPhone 5, buy iPhone 5, be happy. After 6 months, phone is only for communication, it's still doing its job. No physical object, no physical object can give me happiness. Why? Because it doesn't have it. It can give me communication, it can clothe me, it can give me comfort, it cannot give me happiness. Who can give me happiness? Who can give me happiness? Happiness is based on what I create and what I feel. And which means, if I start creating the right feelings irrespective of whatever is the stimulus, which means whether I compliment your dress or I go the other way around, if you're able to create the right thought, then your happiness is constant. Then your happiness is constant. Then it's not dependent on the dress. And it's not dependent on what other people have to say about the dress. Is it possible that everyone will like the dress we buy? Is it possible that everyone will like the dress we buy? This is a very deep belief system. Everybody is supposed to compliment what I buy or what I do. Is it possible that everyone will like the dress we buy? Why? Why? It's their choice. So is it okay if I come up to you and say I don't like what you're wearing?
Why can't you say I like it and I'm wearing it, I don't care for your
opinion. Good. Is it okay, sister, if I come up and say I don't like what you're wearing? But you just now said 10 seconds back, it's okay if I don't like it. No. Is it okay if I voice my true opinion? Why? Because you do not give me the liberty to voice my true opinion. I have got into the practice of lying every time and saying, oh wow, you're looking so beautiful. And andar se saying, eh. We have started living very hypocritical lives because of this. Because other people are not ready to listen to the truth. Because the minute we speak the truth, they will go, tuh. So we want them to be happy, so we just lie. And the more we are doing this, that we are thinking something else, speaking something else, andar to conflict hai. And this conflict cannot let us be happy. If we understood it and accepted it, that everyone's thought process is going to be different, everyone's choices are going to be different, so everyone's opinion is going to be different, everyone would speak the truth. Everyone would speak the truth. The other day a lady called me up, she came from Panipat. She said, I have come all the way from Panipat and I would love to meet you this evening. You know, I said, I'm shooting, so I will not be free this evening. She said, at least you can try. I said, I'm telling you right away that I won't finish before 8, 9 in the evening. So I won't be able to meet you this evening. She said, I'm extremely disappointed. I thought very highly about you after watching you on TV. I'm extremely disappointed by how you've spoken. I said, really? What happened? She said, you've not respected the fact that I've come from so far and you're not even ready to try. I said, I know that I will not be able to make it this evening. You know what she said? At least you should have said to me that you will try. Which means, sach mat bolo, hum dukhi ho jayenge. Aise ho gaye hum. Jhoot bol do khush karne ke liye, sach nahi bolna. Is wajah se hum ek dusre se bahut jhoot bolne lag gaye hain khush karne ke liye. It's not good energy. And she said all that and she put down the phone. After that I was thinking, I said, where was the mistake? What happened? So then I called her up again. And I said, I'm really sorry that what I've said has hurt you. And I have to be very clear to her. I said, I'm sorry that you are hurt, but I'm not sorry that I spoke the truth. I said, because I don't believe in keeping you waiting till 6 o'clock in the evening and then tell you at 6 o'clock in the evening that I will not be able to meet you. I'm going to tell you in the morning itself. But I'm sorry that you are in pain. She said, I appreciate you called, but I'm still not happy with what you have done. I said, no problem. Let the vibrations be very clear between you and me. That's important. We cannot please the world. Why? Because every soul is carrying very, very different sanskars. Very different thought processes. Our thought process will not always match. But we need to take care that in the process of trying to please other people, am I making certain mistakes with my thought process and programming? Just to please you, if I start doing wrong things here, one, long run I'm not going to please you, because I may be speaking very sweetly to you, but I'm sending you something very different from here. I also have the option of saying, you're looking beautiful. Where did you buy this sari? It's looking so nice on you. Your choice is so good. Next time I'm going to go with you to buy my sari. You know, when we have something else inside, we talk too much outside to please the other person. And that's why sometimes we meet people today who are extremely sweet. They are uncomfortably sweet. Because they are hiding something inside that time. So they have to speak a lot to hide their vibrations. Is it fair to not be honest first with ourselves? And because we get into this practice, so when someone else says something to us, we create one thought of doubt. Do they really mean what they are saying? We create this thought. Why? Because we've got used to talking what we are not meaning. So we feel what the other person is saying, do they really mean it? If someone says, this is very nice, we say, did they really like it or did they just say it like that? Because we say it a lot like that. So life has become very, very artificial and very, very complicated. Enjoying life would mean just going back to being your normal self. Your natural self, and most important, to be happy yourself, not to make others happy. Be happy, radiate happiness. That radiating that happiness should be a natural part of our life. A flower carries that fragrance not for us to feel nice about it, but the fragrance is the integral part of that flower. The flower is not blooming to give us happiness, blooming for its own natural living. Natural living. Let us be happy because that's a part of our natural living. When we take up this responsibility, isko bhi khush karna, isko bhi khush karna, isko bhi khush karna, isko bhi khush karna, to tension ho jati hai. Kitne logon ko khush karna hai? Living up to people's expectations. Is a little difficult today. Why? As souls are becoming emotionally weaker, we are in Kali Yuga. Kali Yuga means souls are little emotionally weak. The weaker the soul is, the lesser they are able to create their own happiness, the more they are dependent on other people to be the way they want them to be, for them to be happy. So the list of their expectations is never ending. Expectations are never ending. So even if you do 24 out of 25 things for them, but you're not able to do one, they will forget the 24 and they'll be upset about that one. And most important, when you find them upset about that one, we get unhappy. So we stop radiating our happiness. We cannot afford to stop radiating that. Kyunki aap mere se khush nahi hue, to main dukhi ho gayi. To flower ki fragrance kya ho gayi? Flower ki fragrance kya ho gayi? We have to be like that flower, radiating the fragrance irrespective of whether people like it. Whether people like it or people don't like it. Whether people use it for whatever they want to use it, the flower's not stopping. But if the flower had to start conditioning itself, I will be happy when? When people come and say, what a beautiful rose, I will be happy then. To phir to mushkil ho jayega. Phir to mushkil ho jayega. The more we become emotionally charged, we will shift from expectations to accepting people the way they are. One simple parameter to check whether I'm on the right path of my spiritual journey. We could be doing hours of meditation, days and years of sadhana, but we have to have a marking system. Is the battery getting charged? I'm connecting it to the charger for 10 days, 15 days, half an hour every day, whatever. Is it getting charged? Simple way. Is my acceptance level increasing? Simplest. Because jitna battery charge ho rahi hai, the lesser I need people to be the way I want them to be for me to be happy. Simple equation. Because I'm able to be happy myself, so I don't need you to be the way I want you to be for me to be happy. Because my happiness is now not dependent on you, because my battery is charged. But when battery is discharged, then I'm dependent on you to do things my way for me to be happy. So Kali Yuga mein battery thodi si discharged hai. Our role should be to help that battery to charge themselves. How can we help souls to charge themselves? It will not be by doing things for them every time. How can I help another soul to charge themselves? Yeah, first by being charged myself. So by being charged yourself, what would you be sending me? you will be radiating that charging to me, and that charging will help me to charge myself. That's the biggest gift we can give someone today. That's the best thing we can do for our children today. Empower our children. Today we want to give them the best of everything. We want to give our children the best of everything. What is the best of everything we want to give our children? Best of schooling, best of toys, best of gadgets, best of clothes, best of power. Kaise denge? Pehle apni checking. How much is my expectation level? Day by day kam ho raha ya nahi ho raha? How many feel my acceptance level has increased? How will we check that in the whole day? How will we check that in the whole day? My acceptance level has increased would mean? Less anger, less irritation, more tolerant. How peaceful and happy I am, which means not dependent on others for my happiness. That's soul power. That soul power. The more I am reaching towards that stage, that I am happy, independent of what others are doing or being with me, then I am radiating happiness to them. You're my family, you could be my child, my spouse. I want you to be the way I want you to be. And when you are not that way, I'm either hurt, or I'm worried, or I'm creating fear, or I'm creating pain, so I'm a radiator of negativity. We radiate maximum negativity to the people we claim to love the most. We will worry for them for hours and days, and we'll say, but beta, I love you, no, that's why I worry for you. So I love you, so I'm sending you.
I think I'm radiating happiness to you. And you're not in a position to receive any happiness from anybody. You are.
That shining point of light, the being in the center of the forehead. The conscient energy. The creator of every thought and feeling. I am a pure divine being. I am a pure divine being. This is my true nature. I am a Satyugi divine soul. My every thought heals my body. My every thought radiates to my people. My every thought creates the world. Bring that one person before you. See them sitting right next to you. That one relationship we want to heal. That one soul whom we want to heal. Look at the soul, not the body, not the relationship. Just look at that soul, beautiful soul. I now understand this soul has a past. They've gone through something somewhere because of which they were in pain. it's not their fault at all. It's a past trauma that they were carrying. It's a past and it's over. Bring God just above you, the ocean of love. And see His vibrations touching that soul. Like the sun's rays touch us, the vibration of God's energy is reaching that soul. I, the soul, am also radiating love to this soul. See another laser beam from you to that soul. See it radiating. The wound is getting healed. The past pain is getting resolved. The past karmic account is over. This soul is completely healed. We will do this every morning. Sit, talk to them, say whatever we want to say to them. Forgive them for everything that they have done. Ask them for forgiveness that we had done in the past, which we don't remember. And we will send these focused vibrations of purity and love daily to them, every single day. This is the best gift I can give to any soul. This is the only way I can give love and happiness to them. Om Shanti. Let's do this every morning. Every morning. Can we do this every morning for them? Yes? Simple? Will it work? Will it work? Yes, it will. Yes, it will. Every thought works. And when we healing them, who's the first person who will get healed? We. Because we are creating those pure vibrations. So destiny is in our hands. Thank you so much. Om Shanti.